Well, here we are again, one more time on Marilyn's and My Summer Road Trip, bringing you thought-provoking outdoor locations to enjoy and reflect upon. Remember last week, Marilyn shared her outdoor reflection, weaving thoughts on Canada Day, about our freedom to be our own authentic selves when the truth sets us free, and our gratitude for the blessings we enjoy as Canadians and our relationship with God, who encourages us to be our best selves. So, where do you suppose we will take you today? Well, guess what? Today I'm especially grateful for this time to literally be at home in creation. Betty will also be sharing some other wonderful gardens in her video for this service. So come and open your doors outwards. Come open the door of your true selves to God. Open the door of your senses to God's world, to your sights and sounds and smells and tastes and feelings. Come outside with God together as we enjoy this beautiful outdoor space in my own garden in Sarnia. So welcome. And in this place where I can feel the warm earth in my hands and the sun on my face and the sometimes gentle breezes and the rain that touches the leaves softly, and where I can watch living things grow and reproduce, where I know that God is always present. So let's take this time to explore our own spiritual gardens that we nurture through the fruit of the Spirit. There's never a better time than when creation is so beautifully arrayed as it is in these warm summer days. Days to think about the ways we can steward the land that God has given us and be respectful and delight in all of it. Let us pray. Creator God, we gather in the circle of your generous love, knowing you are here with us, enlightening us, calling us. Everywhere we look, we see your life-giving bounty, from the beautiful flowers and plentiful vegetables and herbs that are nurtured in our home gardens, to the wildflowers that color our roadsides and woodlands, to the luscious foliage that shades us from the heat of the sun and provides fruit enough to generously share. We are grateful for all that your earth provides in its season. Amen. And so I hope you'll sing along with our hymn, I Come to the Garden Alone. It will be printed for you. Thank you. Our scripture lesson this morning is from Genesis, of course. And the Lord planted a garden in Eden, in the east. And there he put the man whom he had formed. And out of the ground the Lord God made to spring up every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food. And the tree of life was in the midst of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. A river flowed out of Eden to water the garden. Thanks be to God for these portions of ancient text to our greater understanding. Amen. This is the time of year when, well, we can easily see God's bounty in our little corner of the world. The corn and beans are making a good show this year. The winter wheat, well, it'll soon be ready to harvest. And as I fancy myself a little bit of a tree hugger, I'm sure to touch our beautiful maples very gently and thank them for the shade that they provide. Our garden gets some extreme heat in the summer, and I'm grateful for every leaf. As you can see, our radishes and carrots in our home garden here are plentiful and plump, and flowers will fill gardens in every neighborhood around here, including this one that we are enjoying today, and our beautiful church gardens that you see so often in Betty's videos. Today is a good day to come into our outdoor gardens to thank God for continuing to bless us with his provisions. I think that before I lived in southwestern Ontario, I might have taken the harvest a little bit for granted. In fact, I know I did. Living in a big city for so many years, I naively assumed that the grocery store, the local farmers market, would take care of everything I needed on a weekly basis on my shopping list. I couldn't have been more wrong. I gave little thought to the intensive labor required to make those amazing fresh fruits and vegetables appear in such quantity every year. Once I was settled in a rural charge 14 years ago, I gained a greater appreciation and respect for our farmers. And now when I see a sign that says, "If you ate today, thank a farmer," well, I pass by, I nod, I smile, and I sure as heck say thank you. And I began to see, well, a question in my heart. What if our very lives depended on a harvest so that we could survive? That's the way farmers look at it. Their very lives depend on it. Perhaps we'd be a whole lot more thankful for the blessings that God has already given us and the labor they provide.
God.
Who likes gardening? And I'm not just talking about all of these beautiful plants and flowers that you see here. While they're amazing to reflect on deeply, and like my little peace garden, help us to find inner peace, I'd like us to think about growing our own food. I remember my mother's garden as we were growing up. How organized it was. Every section of the garden was set aside for a particular vegetable. And there's certain things we need to set aside space for in our spiritual gardens. I've heard that we can plant our gardens this way. First, plant 3 rows of squash. Squash indifference, squash criticism, and squash gossip. Secondly, plant 3 rows of turnips. Turn up to help others. Turn up with a positive attitude. Turn up when you say you will. And thirdly, plant 5 rows of lettuce. Let us be kind. Let us be welcoming. Let us be generous. Let us be patient. And let us be loving. That's a pretty good start on our spiritual gardens, don't you think? If you haven't already, let's get planting. It's never too late to plant your spiritual garden. But each one is unique, don't forget, filled with the blessings of the Spirit and a place where love will always grow. In the meantime, let's be grateful for the beauty of this day as we explore God's creation together.
Grow as nature grows. My children, grow as nature grows. As a tree grows straight and tall, seeking bright sun above the forest canopy, keep your eyes on your goal. Don't let them fall. As old leaves are pushed aside by new shoots, coming up time and again to beautify our world, push past disappointment, drawing strength from your roots. As a tree uses obstacles to make itself strong, wrapping its trunk around stones as it grows, let yourself become stronger when things go wrong. As plants grow from the balance of sun and rain, keep nature's cycles to develop and change. Be ready for life to hand you both pleasure and pain. As hemlocks are among the slowest to grow, helping them to become very strong. Don't rush through life. It's okay to take things slow. As trees sometimes lean on each other to endure the power of wind and storms, you're never alone with your parent or brother. As the plants and animals depend on nature to live, knowing they will have needed food and shelter, remember that God has many gifts to give. My children, grow as nature grows, by Patricia Grotenhouse.
Well, I hope that you have felt as much a sense of gratitude today as I have, journeying through this beautiful garden. God's creation is all around us, spilling forth in glorious expectation that we will look and open our eyes and our hearts and find God right here. In the meantime, as we journey, journey to yet another place of deep reflection in God's world, my prayer is that you will carry with you the love of God, the persistent peace of Christ, and the inspiration of the Holy Spirit walking with us each and every day. Oh, and having said that, I hope you've enjoyed this adventure, and you'll tune in next week to see where we might take you then.
From above, go now in peace.